Good morning, everybody. We are back at the farm. Thanks for being here. Today, morning, Bo. Let's get you some food here. Today, we are, well, let's first check on the cows here. So, we're good there for now. Yeah, we're all right. So, we have got some hay that needs raked up, and we need to do some baling. So, we're going to head over and get started on that. And we will be right back with you. Alright guys, so we made it out here to the field. Got the rakes all set up and going. It's kind of hard to record while I'm doing all that. Takes two hands, really. So, we're going to get this raked up here. And we'll be out with the baler. So, I thought I would talk a little bit about kind of the plan for the day here. And then a couple small announcements. So, today we are going to get this raked up. We're going to round bale this field. We've got plenty of small squares right now. So, we should be good there. And after we get our bales made, we're going to get those hauled in and put in the barn. And then I think, actually we do need to run down and check on our other field where we had some alfalfa down. That's probably about ready to rake too. Gonna need to make sure we get that in. And then, what else are we doing? We are getting pretty close to harvest. Not really too much left to do in the fields besides wait. Gotta hope our fertilizer program and our herbicide programs have paid off, and that we don't have too many weeds, and that we're gonna have some good yields. Then, when we get through harvest, I think it's about time to try to upgrade one of our tractors. I'm hoping that we're going to make enough money this fall to do that without having to go into debt. I'm really trying to keep the farm out of debt, however, sometimes it just doesn't cooperate. So, with that, I am going to try to finish getting this raked up, and we will be back in a little bit with the baler here, and hopefully a tractor with a cab on it that makes it a little easier for you guys to hear me. Alright guys, we are pulling back in at the farm here. We are finished up raking both fields. And we're going to, I think we're just going to go ahead and unhook the rakes here. I don't think we're going to need those again this year. I don't think. We might be able to get another cutting. We'll just have to see. Go. So, I think we'll just drop everything here. Need to grease a few things on this hitch, so I'll try to leave it sitting where I can get to. Yeah, I can get to everything. I better pull it forward a little more. out of it. Okay. We better go put some fuel in there. M over here on the grain auger. Yeah. I've really got to get in gear for harvest here, actually. Kind of check the tractor out while it's filling up here. Well, we should really be thinking about repainting this. A few dings and scratches are one thing, but that's really getting worn here. Alright. We'll look into that another day. Maybe over the winter. So, we will... we're gonna run over here. Hit my hitch. There we go. That ought to be out of the way. Yeah, we can get everything out of here. Okay. And I've been doing some mowing. I think here, we're gonna get this put away. Baling on here. Cows out there doing cow stuff. I hope that's all they're doing. Start doing people stuff and we're in trouble. Okay. We can do here. I'm not doing a very good job of this. Watch out for the green cart. Pretty good. There we go. Alright. Now, for the baler. So this is a pretty good all-around tractor, but getting on to where we need some bigger stuff, so are you not going to cooperate? Where are my hydraulic lines? Okay. Alright. So we're getting on to where we're going to need a little bit bigger tractor. Right now, we've got a 7810. Actually, we better put fuel in this, too, before we take off, because we're going to be gone for a little bit. 7810's just not quite going to cut it for a big tractor anymore. We're running a 6-row plant, or I'm sorry, 16-row planter. And, you know, we've got a little more tillage options here. The disc and the chisel plow, they're really, I can only pull those with the four-wheel drive. And you know, I've only got the one four-wheel drive, so I think maybe we're going to try to put the 7810 on grill, the 1590 grill, and maybe the cultivator, you know, mid-size stuff that it would be well suited for. And then it could also, well, like right now, you know, we could run the baler on that. We could haul manure with it, you know, all the mid-sized farm chores that you don't really need a huge tractor for, but a little bit of horsepower is nice. Be a little overkill, but, you know, it would work. I really think a 6R is going to be where we want to get to. And, you know, they're pricey brand new, but I think we can make it work. We're going to have to check on our harvest income here, see how things do, and go from there. If we can't make it happen this year, I think definitely next year is going to be the plan. So, gotta watch my scales here, make sure I'm not plugging up the baler. This year just would not cooperate for hay. We've had this down for a while. It stayed cool and damp. We've not had good drying weather at all. We're getting close to the end of summer, and it's only 64 degrees out, you know. no heat wave by any means. So, unfortunately, we had to leave this way for quite a while. I'm sure we lost quite a bit of nutrient value out of it. We're going to, luckily cows aren't too picky on hay. Not like horses would be. But, we should be alright with this. Didn't see any mold when I was raking. Stopped and checked it a few times, and not seeing any mold or anything, but I'm sure we've lost nutritional value, so it is what it is. Sometimes the weather's just against you. Sure, I'm pulling some of this taller green grass back into the baler too. Now, I should have raked this out into the field better. Alright guys, well, I am going to put the camera down here for a little bit, try to get this field knocked out, and I will get back with you when we get over to our next field, which is the alfalfa. Got that all raked up also, so we will be back in just a bit. Alright guys, we are finishing up last bale and a half here of alfalfa hay. Got some weeds down here. We're going to have to get in here and spray. Try to keep the chemicals off the cattle feed as much as I can, but I don't think these weeds are going to give us any options. We'll get in here and get that done in the near future. look at that. Worked out just perfect. Alright. So we're gonna head home and grab a truck and trailer, get the skid loader and bale spear, and we're gonna go start picking up bales. We'll see you soon. Hey guys, so we got everything baled up, got the baler home. Now we are heading back out. Had my son bring the round bale trailer down, and I am bringing the skid loader down here. Make sure we don't hit that stop sign. My son should be down here by now. We will just get him all loaded up with bales. He can take them back to the barn. Let's see here. Try not to block us in too bad. I think we'll be all right here. Okay. Oh, they already got the ramps put down for me. Awesome. Okay, so we are just gonna start scooping up some bales here. I think we're going to start the back end of the field. We'll work our way back. These big round bales, this skid loader won't pick up two at a time, so makes it kind of tedious, but it's not that bad. Just wish I didn't have to run over my alfalfa quite so much, though. That's the only thing. This would be a lot easier if these bales weren't quite so heavy. But we'll make it work. May just have to start thinking about investing in a little bit bigger skid loader. Or loader tractor, which I don't think we'd really have that much use for a loader tractor, so probably not the best way to go. Yeah, first two bales are loaded. is. It's a little bit of a pain trying to keep the camera steady for you guys here. But, actually we're gonna... This is really shady. You don't want to pick up stuff off-center like this, but kind of have to be able to see how side heavy that is. I was trying to get a little tippy there, but to fit in here these big bales, don't have a lot of choice but to pick them up this way. It's not the most safe thing, but kind of missed. It's not very good at all. There we go. Really what it's designed to do, but it works and we just got to get her done. Holds a lot of moisture. It's a little slippy right there. Next one up here. A couple of bales kind of far away. Get those. I can get two more on the bottom here. These big bales don't really fit on that trailer very well, but just throw a couple extra straps on it and it works. Alright guys, I'll tell you what. I'm gonna get this, I'm gonna finish loading this trailer up here and we'll bring you back in when we get home. Okay, so I wasn't real comfortable with my boy hauling this home. So I went ahead and you can see he's loading up the skid loader there. Just got to get it chained down and we'll be off and going. But yeah, I decided I would go ahead and bring this one home. We're definitely a little overloaded. And this cart can get a little tippy pretty easy, or trailer, I mean. So, yeah, I figure just in case anything happens, we'll let that happen to me and not him. So we're just gonna take our time here, nice and easy, heading home. Surprised I don't see the neighbors out doing anything. Maybe they went on vacation. Sure looks like they got everything closed up tight. So, don't think we're going to get too much more done today. It's been, been kind of time consuming dealing with these bales. As you can see, we're not making up any more time here. Gotta take it easy getting home. And gonna bring them up here and put them in the barn. Gonna park beside the barn and then get the skid loader up here and we'll get them offloaded and put away. Get that done yet today. And really, I need to get out there and get those bales. Quite a few more there. They're close to home, so I figured I would I'd start a little farther away from home and work my way back. So here, where do I want to put these? I guess we'll swing around in here. There we go. Oh, getting wobbly. All right. So, as soon as my boy gets back, we'll get these unloaded. I'm going to say thanks for checking out the video today. Hope you guys found something you enjoyed. And as always, you're welcome back anytime. Come on by, see what we're doing, what we're all about. Hopefully you find something you enjoy, something you like, and something you can learn. So until next time, y'all take care.